It's My Life, the program that brings you face to face with the top politicians of the country. This week we are in the state of Orissa, in the town of Lord Jagannath, the constituency of Puri. And our guest is a young suave face of Biju Janata Dal, who's not only a Lok Sabha MP from Puri, but also a legal luminary. Let's go on a journey with Pinaki Misra this time. Biju Janata Dal MP from Puri, Pinaki Misra, was born on October 23, 1959. Educated at St. Xavier's, he pursued law from St. Stephen's, Delhi. He's one of the very few politicians who practice law along with politics. Apart from being a vociferous and an articulate leader of Biju Janata Dal, he also specializes in corporate law, not only in the Supreme Court, but across the high courts in the country.
Prime Minister said there should not be elections every 6 months. What he meant to say was, I didn't want to remain Prime Minister only for 6 months. That's what he said, and that's what this JPC must decide.
Elected to the 11th Lok Sabha for the first time, Pinaki was part of the Congress initially, but quit in 2009 because of major differences. Pinaki is blessed with a son and a daughter. The constituency of Puri is divided into seven assembly segments, and therefore Pinaki prefers to stay at Bhubaneswar and take petitions from the people. Time now for the morning Janta Darbar. Pinaki, welcome on It's My Life.
Thank you, Nilu, for welcome to Bhubaneswar.
So now I think we are heading off to Puri.
Yes, we are off to Puri.
Okay, so join us at Puri. Right now we are at the Puri District Bar Association, which is supposed to be one of the very robust bar associations in the country. Pinaki is here to meet the lawyers as well as donate something through his MP lab.
It is your job now to keep the SEC sector flowing. Supposing something happens to you, who will be the one who is responsible? What is the estimate?
Thank you.
Pinaki, we've seen that you are quite dependent on your MLAs. Is it got to do with the fact that you're also a working lawyer, a professional, and you're not able to devote that kind of time?
No, I don't think that's the only reason. Mm. That's maybe 10% of the reason. Mm. I think 90% of the reason is because the BJD is a MLA-oriented party.
Okay.
And, you know, if an MP interferes too much in the constituency, it may lead to factionalism. So, I stick to what is the classical, traditional MP's role.
Macro-managing things.
Of macro-managing everything. I take advice, opinions of my MLAs.
But too much of reliance on the MLAs, can't it be a setback? Maybe, I hope it is not ever, but it can prove to be a setback at some point of time.
It's never been a setback with me because, you know, they know I don't create factionalism in the party. I think my predecessor, in fact, that's the problem they had with him. That he was too involved with the constituency and there was enormous factionalism.
What are the biggest challenges of Puri?
I think the greatest failure of Puri has been the Puri municipality, unfortunately.
Okay.
I've managed to get large funds from the centre, from the Jawaharlal Nehru, the JNRRUM. But they have not been able to use those funds.
What is the reason? What is the reason?
The reason is the same as all municipalities all over India.
Lack of coordination.
The lack of coordination, the lack of will, the lack of cohesion. So there's enormous pressure on the civic amenities. And it's a great challenge. We have somehow met the challenge, but we could have done much better.
One of the Jagaghars in the temple town of Puri. The word Jagaghar means these are watchtowers of Lord Jagannath.
You know, this is a place for congregation,
okay.
A place for their exercise, for their entertainment.
Okay.
So it's all very healthy and very positive.
Like, and somewhat like a gymnasium.
That's right.
Okay.
And Puri is famous for this.
Okay.
It's called Jagaghara.
Jagaghara.
You know, the old style akhadas, where these young boys are all becoming very proficient at wrestling. Puri is famous for its wrestlers. But now, as they are saying that, you know, even in the Olympics now, it's all mats.
Okay.
So they're probably now going to do away with the mud style wrestling.
Gote choto breaker nobha.
Bohut bhalo. Apno udia bohut bhalo kahiliya. Thank you.
Well, let's take a break at this point in time and return with lots more on Pinaki Mishra. Back in a moment. Now we are off to Chilka on a chopper, crossing the green mountains and nature's serene beauty.
Come on, come on, come on.
People welcoming their adorable Neta. Oh,
ancestral village.
Okay.
Banpur. Uh-huh.
Pinaki waiting to welcome the governor, Dr. S.C. Jameer. We've reached a place called Banpur, which is part of the Chilka Assembly constituency, and we are at Godavari Ish Mahavidyalaya, which is celebrating its Golden Jubilee function.
এই মাটির দায় আপনার ভাই আপনার পুয় আপনার সাথী সহযোগী আপনার আশীর্বাদ গ্রহণ করছি আপনার সেবার নিবৃত অছি বহুত বহুত ধন্যবাদ।
Orissa is a state which everyone has seen in the last 10 years the way it has come up, the infrastructural growth and the kind of growth, but what is the main source of growth then? How is Orissa growing right now? You said that the royalty, the mineral royalty is a pittance and there is not cooperating with the state.
Yes, but you know, I mean ultimately the royalties may be a pittance, but when industries come in, there is industrialization. That has a number of spin-offs, so therefore there is employment being generated, there is a lot of ancillary industries are set up.
The places where mining has come up, the kind of growth which was expected, I mean I'm talking about the overall growth of that particular place, why is it that that kind of growth has not come up in those areas?
I agree. That's something that I'm in complete agreement with. I think those areas should have been far more developed by now in terms of airport connectivity, in terms of national highway connectivity. In terms of port connectivity. But I'm sorry to have to repeat myself again, most of this is controlled by the center.
Okay.
The state governments have a very limited capacity to both conceive and then conceptualize and then pay.
You've been in Orissa and you've seen the state growing, you've seen the ups and downs of the states. What do you think is the biggest deficiency right now as far as the governance is concerned? Where do you really need to work upon at this point in time?
I think it's very difficult to get together an enlightened bureaucracy in India. You know, the system that the British have left us is so heavily bureaucratic.
Right.
It's very difficult to get a good collector, for instance. We have been unable to build up a cadre of bureaucracy.
I've met a lot of people from Orissa who have this perception. I might be wrong, you have to correct me for that if it is. They say that the bureaucracy is much more powerful than the politicians here. It's a bureaucracy driven state. So is it, how far is it true?
Look, every state in India is bureaucracy driven.
Okay.
Whoever says that any state is not bureaucracy driven is talking through his hat, because our system in India is such. Mm. We are bureaucracy driven. Mm. The politicians only guide as far as policy making is concerned.
Okay.
The actual execution is always in the hands of the bureaucracy. Mm. So Orissa is no different.
A large section of people whom I met, they even said that sometimes the politicians even blindly sign on the papers which the bureaucrats bring in.
I don't think that's quite correct. I think one or two cases, there may be.
But since the exit of Pyari Mohan Mahapatra, don't you think that his exit has affected the prospects of the party in any way? Because he was handling everything, was at the helm of affairs.
It's a myth to think that he was handling everything. You'd be very surprised how hands-on Naveen Patnaik has always been. Mm-hmm. He has always been very, very hands-on. Mm-hmm. I think the only thing, frankly, that Pyari Babu was becoming accountable for was the good cop, bad cop.
Okay.
In Orissa, where some of the unpleasant decisions had to be taken, were attributed to Pyari Babu.
Will BJD be ready to take him back if he wants to come back?
Personally speaking, I think things have now gone too far.
But what was the main reason why you switched from Congress to BJD?
Vast army of courtiers in Delhi, you know, who have appropriated the authority of, you're not a, you know, acolyte or a sycophant of some of these courtiers in Delhi, you have no future.
So it was Naveen Patnaik who called you, or you went to him?
Well, I mean, you know, once the Congress party again played with my ticket in 2009.
Okay.
You know, I got a call saying, why are you suffering this humiliation there?
Okay.
You know, there's a place for you in our party and our hearts.
And now to the largest wintering ground for migratory birds on the Indian subcontinent, the Chilka Lake, which is home to a number of threatened species of plants and animals.
We are right now at India's largest brackish water lagoon, that is a famous Chilka Lake. Pinaki, what this area has developed into a tourist spot, but what are the biggest challenges which you're facing right now here?
I think connectivity is our number one challenge, because we really need air connectivity in these parts. Once you have air connectivity, you will find this is one of the most beautiful natural locations anywhere in this country,
right,
as you can see for yourself. We have rail connectivity, fortunately.
Okay.
But we need more frequency of rail connectivity.
But what is the kind of footfalls in terms of the tourists who are coming in, a rough footfall?
We get a very large footfall from Bengal.
Okay.
Traditionally, Orissa has a very large footfall from West Bengal, whether it is Gopalpur or Chilka this side, or it is Chilka on the other side along with Puri.
Okay.
It's and of course Konark, as our Honorable MLA reminds me, it's a world famous sun temple.
Right.
So yeah, we get a very, very large local footfall, but I think we need a more international footfall. I think the Honorable Chief Minister now is very keen to set up Odisha as part of the Buddhist circuit.
Okay.
Because once it gets integrated into the Buddhist circuits, I think the Japanese are going to flock to this place.
Yeah.
So so hopefully tourism, that's, you know, it's a self growth process.
Right. See, this is something again that is peculiar to Puri. Many of these small lanes, by lanes, are not accessible by road.
Okay.
By car. So I always have motorcycles.
Okay.
You know, as backup.
Okay, okay.
Somebody or the other will be on a there'll be 5-6 motorcycles.
Okay.
Which I will sit on.
Okay, and just zip off.
And zip.
Okay.
Cars cannot access. So I find it most convenient. I have these 8, 10, 12 committed boys who are good drivers on bikes. Very important, because I don't want to take a toss.
But what about election time? Election time also.
Oh yeah, yeah.
These
this
bikes.
Is absolutely, because you can't reach these areas by car.
Yeah.
Meet the MP program was quite hectic and tiring, so time for a short lunch break. While I enjoy the food, we come back on the other side.
Welcome back. You're watching It's My Life with Mr. Pinaki Misra, and joining me now is Pinaki's wife and son, Sangeeta Misra and Dhanraj. Welcome both of you on the show. I'd like to start with you, Pinaki. How did you actually enter politics, given the fact that you were from a political family? Was it by choice, or you had decided that you are going to join politics?
you know, my entire childhood, the Central Hall of Parliament was my playfield. Those days, you didn't have all these security trappings. So I would come back from school, go straight to Parliament, have lunch there,
okay,
watch debates all afternoon. So I've spent all my life, you know, and you could walk into the Lok Sabha Visitors Gallery, the Rajya Sabha Visitors Gallery, it's the Central Hall, the fantastic ice cream parlors there. So it was the most natural place for me to be. My father was an MP from 1960 to 1978. So I was 6 months old when I went to Delhi.
So you actually grown up with politics?
I've actually grown up in Parliament.
But what about you, Dhanraj? Like, you're spending the same kind of time which your dad had spent?
No, I couldn't actually. When I was younger, I had better opportunities to go to Parliament, but unfortunately, post 2001, with all the securitization that's taken place of our main institutions, the People's Hall is really not accessible to most of the people, sadly. But I have strong memories of dad taking me during his first term in the Lok Sabha.
But how about you, ma'am? Like, with his life in the court, then with his life as a politician, do you get enough time to spend with him?
We have to make the time. What do you do? You have to find the time.
Optimize the time together.
Okay.
I think there's not a single moment as a family or as a couple that we waste.
Okay.
Every moment has to be optimized.
But you've never been those cribbing wives that, oh, he's not spent enough time with me. You've never been like that.
No, in fairness, she's always wanted me to carve out a political career for myself. She's always encouraged it, and she's always encouraged me to work, because, you know, that's where the money comes from. So I have to practice law. She likes that. So whenever I'm in Delhi, I think what's become a casualty is our social life. I think we tend to go out much less now.
But Sangeeta, tell me honestly, Which personality is better, Pinaki the lawyer or Pinaki the politician?
I think the politician.
Pinaki the politician is more appealing to you. What about you, Dhanraj?
They're indistinguishable for me, because the way he is demanded to switch from his role as politician to lawyer, and the abruptness with which he is demanded to do that, it becomes very difficult to keep a track on what mode he's on, because he has to answer a call from his constituency, he's back to politics, and then he's back to law. And he has to do this admirable balancing act all the time.
It's not easy, as not everybody can do this, switching from law to politics.
You know, it's very difficult. I'll tell you why. Suddenly, at one level, you're dealing with a matter involving hundreds of millions of dollars. And, you know, you're sitting with solicitors from the UK, from lawyers from America, and, you know, and then the next, you know, 2 hours later, You've seen my constituency. It's a rural constituency, very down to earth, very earthy, very good, noble souls. So the switch from meeting those people, the language that you have to employ with them, and then to come back to this persona, I think that's what sometimes I find very difficult.
But during the campaigns and all, you accompany him, and you are there as a shadow always while he is on the
campaign?
Not always.
I think she does. She handles a lot of the women voters.
Okay.
And Dhanraj in the last election was very popular with the youngsters.
Okay.
So yeah, election time is carnival time in India. The whole family always gets together, and everybody pitches in.
But what is it with you, Dhanraj? I presume you're doing law, you told me. So you also plan to join politics, or what is it?
No, there's no question of joining politics. It's very unpredictable, and I think any entry into politics has to be by conviction and conviction only.
So, you know, Pinaki's grandfather told his father not to enter politics. His father told him not to enter politics, and he's telling his son, no, don't enter politics.
So okay, then my so father-in-law, you better be prepared.
So father-in-law said, yes, my father told me not to enter. And his father himself was a minister in Orissa, you know. And so
yeah, she went to the school yesterday where there was a
golden jubilee. So I think every father tells his son ki beta isme mat karo, you know.
So who knows, this generational defiance might be repeated.
I think in the back of the mind somewhere you've got to be prepared that, you know, sometimes you've got to enter politics. Now tell me, what about passions like reading? I believe you're a very good singer, we've already seen that. So how do you
not anymore. I think all this shouting in court and outside is really, my voice is gone now, so I don't think I'm a great singer anymore.
Tumhara इंतजार है तुम
पुकार लो, ख्वाब चुन रही है रात बेकरार है तुम्हारा इंतजार।
10 years is a long time in politics, but how do you really want him to grow maybe in the next 10 years?
Who can say in politics what's going to evolve? So I cannot even think about it. You know, politics is, it's like snakes and ladders. You can be there at 99 and then down to zero. Haven't we all seen that? Happens a lot in politics. So I cannot say.
Okay, so Pinaki,
I think that's why God's been so kind that he gives me the fallback of law. Even if there's lack of success in politics, I'm very happy to go back to law and serve people equally.
I'm sure the aspiring lawyers are going to learn from you a lot. Pinaki, it was a pleasure having you in It's My Life. Thanks very much.
Thank you very much, Neelu.